Good evening, my name is Andrea Lazarte. I'm a last year student of Environmental Engineering at the Molina Agrarian University of Peru and Executive Director of the Mars Society Peru. Today I will present you Crew 126 results of planetary analog EVA medical emergency simulations. I was part of Crew 126 where, together with Alejandro Diaz from the Boeing Company, A.G. Onchi, Humberto de las Casas, Saul Trujillo, and Monica Abarca from Pontifical University of Peru, who studies mechatronics engineering. We perform simulations about emergency procedures. Together, we mainly focus on several configurations of stretchers and so on. As you know, the red planet contains all the elements needed to support life, with a surface area the size of the combined continents of the Earth. Moreover, as the nearest planet with all these required resources for civilization establishment, this will be the decisive trial whether humanity can expand from its globe of origin and conquer other planets in the space, such as Mars. In that regard, future NASA planetary exploration will call out for human establishment in the space with long-term missions to Moon, Mars, and other planets. This human presence in extraterrestrial locations will need extravehicular activity, which involve dangerous procedures that can put in risk the crew safety. These simulations were performed in the Mars Analog Research Station in different parts of the world. We, as Crew 126, were at Utah's research station. A Mars-like environment is defined by its distribution of living organisms, organic matter, chemical properties of the soil. If it's chosen properly, it can guide the investigations about possible environments like Mars. This Mars analog site provides an excellent location for medical research, and we can perform different investigations about medical science and other remote space science. To this end, one of the main goals of Crew 126 was to assess EVA emergency rescue equipment and procedure, focusing mainly on different configuration of stretchers and proving this in different terrains like rough terrain, medium terrain, and flat smooth terrain. What does an EVA mean? As you all know, an EVA is any activity performed by a pressurized solid crew member in an unpressurized environment, which can be internal or external to habitable modules. These activities may include other activities such as base construction, base operation and maintenance, emergency and safety procedures, etc. In cases where EVA crew members are faced with real medical emergency, they will have to be transported back to the pressurized habitat, as you can see in the figure. Then they will have to go and undergo the repressurization cycle. They will have to be, after that, remove the spacesuit, and then the emergency treatment will be initiated. To help mitigate this EVA emergency, astronaut training programs will spend substantial attention in preparing for planetary surface operations. Our crew 126, performed these 10 EVA emergency transportation research. As you can see, we proved two crew members carrying a stretcher and an ATV, two-wheel stretcher in series, one-wheel stretcher, two-wheel stretcher in parallel, pulled by up 30-degree hill, towed by an ATV, and the average speed walk in a space that also has been done by NASA, use of an emergency ladder, and the EV connector test. I will describe in detail all of these emergency simulations we perform. First of all, I would like to detail detail the terrains we perform these EVAs. We chose these kind of terrains. The first one, the rough terrain, we chose a terrain with an even slope and big amount of rocks. The transportation mainly was difficult in this terrain. In the medium terrain, there were less amount of rocks. The slope was uneven, but the transportation was much more easier than the previous one. And in the flat, smooth terrain, there were no presence of rocks, and the slope was almost none. So the transportation was pretty easy here. The first EVA we performed was the crew members carrying the stretcher. We used first four crew members carrying the stretcher. The first, we used this EVA to prove a method of transportation an EVA injured crew member on an emergency stretcher. The stretcher we used was a standard military stretcher that was modified by us to fit the backpack. As you can see, we took the center part of the stretcher and put like straps, red straps, to fit the backpack. The height and the strength of the crew members were distributed in the stretcher to load, to even out the load. So the test subject in every case was me, so I had to experience all the difficulties of these EVAs, not as the one who carried, but the one who was tested the test subject. Overall, the total weight of the stretcher, the test subject, and the spacesuit was 180.2 pounds, as you can see. We proved two positions. The first one was the prone position, is that figure over there. So the conclusion of this was that mainly was uncomfortable. The portable life support system couldn't let the crew member to breathe. And in case of a spine neck injury, the crew member wouldn't have able to breathe and move the neck. So also, the injured crew member wasn't able to see the EVA paramedic, so for that reason, she couldn't communicate as well. On the other hand, in the supine position, the transportation was much more comfortable, so between these two, we conclude that the better position was the supine position. We attempt the same EVA, but with only two crew members carrying the stretcher. This meant a heavy design. However, while two crew members were carrying the stretcher, the other two could rest. So from that part, it was a benefit for them that it was already tiring to carry this amount of weight, distance of 210 meters that was from a point to the hub. This was the second EVA. We used a stretcher adapter to place the stretcher in the EVA, as you can see. The stretcher adapter was made of wood and screws to secure it. We used the rope also to secure the stretcher adapter to the ATV to make the cover. The cover you can see there. We used plastic, foil, tubes, and rope to make it. So we use the ATV adapter and the stretcher and the test subject to go a distance of 210 meters back to the hub. The main observation of this EVA was that the ATV driver couldn't sit down because the stretcher adapter blocked the seat. So this was the recommendation, is maybe to make a smaller ATV stretcher adapter, or to use other materials that can allow to the ATV driver to sit. But overall, the test subjects felt comfortable, and the ATV adapter and the ATV cover, cover efficiently the test subject and protected from the sun, the wind, and the dust. For the two-wheel stretcher in series, we placed two bicycle wheels below the stretcher and made a trapezoid structure with steel pipes to secure it. As you can see the measures there. In the rafter, we proved all these EVAs on the three different types of terrain that I already mentioned. So in the rough terrain, the test subjects felt uncomfortable because every time the crew members bumped a rock, she bumped her head with the helmet, so it was very hard. The same happened in the medium terrain, but overall was the level of comfort was a little bit more than the before. And in the flat, smooth terrain, there wasn't any kind of discomfort for the test subject. On the one-wheel stretcher, we used the same distribution and structure than before, but with only one wheel placed on the center of the stretcher. As you can see in the figure, the measures are shown. We once again proved this in three different terrains. So in the rough terrain, the test subject felt unstable again, but this time because it was harder to maneuver for the crew members, and she felt unstable just like in the medium terrain. In the flat, smooth terrain, she felt secure, but it was also a little bit unstable. The harder part in this EVA was for the crew members because they had to struggle with just one wheel and the weight of the stretcher and the test subject on it. This time we proved a two-wheel stretcher, but in parallel. And this time we made two attempts because the first one didn't work. The first attempt failed because there was a big gap between the wheels and the load was unevenly distributed, so the structure fell and we have to make another one. We resecured all the connections, especially the one for the right wheel that was mainly the one that supported all the weight, and also put the structure closer to the center to even out the load from the front and the back. We once again tried this configuration in the three different terrains. In the first terrain, she felt a little bit unstable, but better than in the previous EVA. It is important to mention that this time in the medium terrain, the crew members put a helmet pad in the helmet so that the test subject felt more comfortable, so this really worked and improved the level of comfort. In the flat small terrain, the crew member didn't feel any kind of discomfort because they already put the helmet pad in the helmet. For the four-wheel stretcher pulled up a 30-degree hill, we based on a NASA research that was made in 2006, as you can see in the image, NASA already proved this EVA, but they didn't put any wheels. So for them was harder to transport the crew members in this kind of stretcher. We modified that EVA they made and put four small wheels on the ITV, not the stretcher, sorry. And we proved it on a 30-degree hill, a distance of 40 feet up the hill. The rope that we used was already rated, so we proved that it can load, that can carry the load from the stretcher and the test subject. A recommendation for this EVA was to place a foot stopper on the bottom of the stretcher so that the subject couldn't fall down as she was pulled up the hill. We can maybe conclude that this may be the better and the fastest way to transport a crew member because the ATV was fastest and the other crew members wouldn't have to carry all the weight to the hub or the pressure hub to the injured crew member. This was the last EVA with the stretcher. We used the same configuration that the previous one, but this time we attempt to carry and transport the test subject a distance of 2 miles back to the habitat just by using an ATV, but in a flat, smooth terrain. The only problem with this EVA was that the rope kept getting tangled with the stretcher wheels. So we recommend to put a metal structure instead of the rope next time we approve this EVA. We did a MDRS average speed test using just four of us who did this EVA. As you know, anytime an astronaut gets out a vehicle, it's called a spacewalk. So a spacewalk is also considered an EVA. NASA already did a lot of this type of studies, but related to the moon. So we, and Mars as well, but we wanted to test this at MDRS to prove and determine the maximum waypoint crew members should go during an EVA at MDRS. This EVA also intended to prove how long would the crew members have to walk in case of an ATV failure, and also prove the communications range during this EVA. The crew walk a distance of 2.78 kilometers from the hub to a point, and the same distance from that point back to the hub, and took about 3 hours to complete this EVA. The results was that the average walking speed was 2.57 kilometers per hour, that my teammate already mentioned in the previous presentation, but we can affirm that this is closer to the NASA research that they have already done. Also, we perform an emergency ladder simulation. We use just a regular ladder that we secured in rocks with just screws and rope, and we tested to use it as a tool to go up and down in case of an emergency rescue mission. So we successfully test and prove that a ladder can be used in an ascent and descent procedure. Finally, we performed the EVA connector test. This was a replica of the ISS connector and was from Boeing. So we proved this test just to appreciate the difficulty to work in the pressurized glove. For this matter, we had to use two pairs of latex gloves before using the ski gloves on. From that instance, we can prove and simulate the stiffness of the pressurized glove, the actual pressurized gloves from the space. This has been proposed, as I told you, to simulate the stiffness of the pressurized spacesuit gloves. So each of my crew members, including me, proved this connector, just connecting and removing the connector mock-up, not power. We conclude that at least we had to make two attempts to successfully remove and connect this connector. As a conclusion, for the stretcher configurations, we can say that using the ATV and the stretcher was better than using just the crew members, because it was easier and faster to transport the crew members this way. On the wheel configurations, we can say that a two parallel configuration was better, because it was like a combination of the two previous ones, the one in series and the one with one wheel. So even though it was the weight was a little unbalanced with the crew members, they had a lot of liberty to move, and the maneuver was easier, and the transportation was easy as well. As I told you, a spacewalk is an EVA, so we successfully determined the Mars MDRS walking speed. The emergency ladder can be used as a tool to prove a rescue mission to go up and down a hill or just a cliff. And the EVA connector test is important, because we could determine the stiffness of the pressurized gloves that will actually be used in space, and it is used in space just now. Probably we'll be using the missions to Mars that we probably be soon, we perform soon. So thank you very much. And if you have a question, please feel free to tell me. And there is my email if you want to know about the Mars Society for Boswell. Thank you.
Considering the low gravity of Mars, I don't know that weight is going to be so much of a problem. If there are two other crew members to evacuate the injured party, you might have fewer problems, no matter what he or she weighs, just using an ordinary stretcher, because the weight would be only half or a third. The maximum percent, but not the weight.
Yeah, like the gravity of Mars is one third of here on Earth. We know that the weight may not be a bigger issue, but if the crew members are performing this type of simulation or emergency, real emergency activities with all the spacesuits on it, it will be represent a major difficulty. That's why we perform these simulations at the MDRS. Just for that, because we know the weight may not be the bigger issue. So if there's no more questions, thank you very much for the attention.